So anyway, on this Tuesday, I was just getting ready to come in here to do the thought for the day, and one of you comes to the door, and he hands me like $30 to put in the love bucket, and he said, "I just want to thank you and the people at the church for doing these thoughts for the day." And he said, I drive by on my way to and from work every day about noon, and I look at the church and I think of you, and I just want to say thanks to you and the others that make it possible. And I said, you know, I told him, I said, sometimes after all these times, I feel like I say the same thing over and over and over, and maybe people get tired of it. And he said, "Hey, Don, it's not so much what you say. It's just every day when I tune in, it's a reminder that the church is still here. Because you see the altar and you see the candles and you see some chairs and the shirts, and it's just a reminder, even if nobody said anything, it's a reminder that the church is here and always will be. And there will be a day when we can come back, but the church is the church." I was thinking of a simple scripture from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 29, where Jesus tells those listening, he says, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart." You know, when you hear the word yoke, you think of something that kind of is a burden that you have to carry around. But Jesus' yoke is different. You know, I don't know about you, but I go through times when I feel a little bit harsh, when I get a little bit angry. And maybe it's anger because this whole virus, this whole journey thing has kept us away from some of the people that we love the most, that it's changed the way we interact. And there's a temptation once in a while, even for me, to get angry for what this thing has done to the church, because it's kind of forced us to be different than the way we want to be. Instead of coming together, we're staying apart, and that sometimes can get very frustrating. But then, when I feel myself getting a little harsh and a little angry, I think of those words of Jesus: "I am gentle and humble in heart." That's the way I want to be. Wherever this leads us, and all those things that happen to us that we don't like, to step back and be gentle and try to be humble and somehow, some way, never let anger and harshness get in the way of that power of kindness. I'm wondering, when you have a tendency to get a little off kilter, when you feel like maybe your soul is getting a little bit wrinkled, do you have somebody that you think of that reminds you of the power of gentleness and humility? Sometimes I think of my dad. You know, each one of us has somebody that we think of, whether it's a parent or a grandparent or a good friend. And my dad, unlike me, he was humble and he was gentle and he was a man of few words. I remember, and I've probably told this story in my sermons over the past few years, I remember when I first came into town, and I had an old car, and within a week, the car just crashed. And so I kind of put my tail between my legs, and I called my dad, and I said, "Dad, I need help. You know, I just got here at the church. I really don't have any money, and I need a car." And so I got a car, and my dad loaned me the money. And unlike him, he made me sign a contract, and I had to make a payment of like $25 or $50 a month. And so I signed the contract and gave it to my dad, and I remember paying my first payment, and about 3 or 4 days after I made my first payment, I got a certified letter in the mail, and I go, "Oh no, what did I do wrong?" I opened it up, it was a copy of the contract, and on it was stamped, "Poom, paid in full." And I thought to myself, that's my dad. I thought of my dad, and I think of God's love. I think of what Jesus did. And in so many ways, my weaknesses and indiscretions, and when I fall short, there's a higher power out there that says, paid in full, that my love is unconditional and it's always going to be there. You know, I was thinking, I was always trying to ask my dad how much money he made, and he would never tell me. I said, "Dad, how much money do you make?" And he would look up and say, "I make enough." I think of those words, enough, and I realize that sometimes I'm always trying to get more or be more or do more, and then I realize that it's enough. It's enough to love. It's enough to be patient. It's enough not to have very much. That sometimes, instead of always wanting more, just look at what's around me, look at what's around us, look at the gifts that we have, and maybe we do have enough. And for those of you that don't have enough, for those of you who just don't even have enough to go out to the store and get what you need to get, just like that gentleman that walked in the door, he wanted to make sure that there was some money in the bucket to give unto others. And that's what we're about. Please, don't be afraid to ask for help. One of the people that works here, one of her friends has a small business, and just on the spontaneously, we gave her some money just so that she could somehow maybe pay the rent or pay her employees who were laid off. And she called yesterday and said, "I don't understand a church that would give money to somebody they don't even know." Well, you know, paid in full. Enough is enough. Unconditional love. There are no strangers here. We're all in this together. And God's love binds us together, and your goodness does too. Hey, it's good to talk to you today. It feels good. I miss seeing you, but I know you're here. And tomorrow's Wednesday, and we'll be back at noon. God bless you all.